Leaders employing the force of appreciation for multiplication. Employing the force of appreciation for multiplication. And it simply means using appreciation to get your multiplication. Using appreciation to get multiplication. Appreciation is another word for thanksgiving. Appreciation is another word for thanksgiving. Multiplication is another word for addition. Appreciation either to God or man has the ability and power to multiply whatever you are appreciating God for. It has the power, it has the ability to multiply anything you are appreciating God for. When you thank God for his finger, you will see his mighty hand. If you thank God for where you are now, he will take you to where you're supposed to be. If you thank him for your position now, no matter the position notwithstanding, then God will take you to your position that you're supposed to occupy. He will take you to the position you're supposed to occupy. If you thank him for where you are now, I don't care how where you are now looks like. I don't care where you are now, how is it is now. But I tell you, if you begin to thank God for where you are now, he will take you to where you're supposed to be. When we were five members in conference house, we always thank God for five people. We became seven, we thank God for seven people. We thank God for where we are going. As we keep growing, we keep thanking God for our past. The Bible says that the path of the just is like a shining light that shineth brighter and brighter. It shineth more and more unto the perfect day. When you begin to thank God for where you are now, God causes your path to begin to shine. Amen. If you thank God for the little he has done for you, he will give you more. When you appreciate God for the little, he will add to it. That's why the Bible said in Jeremiah 30 verse 19, that from the mouth of the people who thank God, who appreciate him, and the mouth of people who are happy and rejoicing because of his goodness towards them, he said he is going to multiply them, and they shall not be few. He is also going to glorify them, and they shall not be small. Which means that when you begin to thank God, when your heart begins to pant after his praise, God begins to pant after to raise you. And I see God raising you from every obscurity you may find yourself in the name of Jesus Christ. As you begin to thank God, because this week is our week of praise, as you begin to thank God and praise him this week, his glory shall come down and he shall raise you from where you are to where you're supposed to be in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And I said just at the first service that appreciation goes with singing and with dancing. Appreciation goes with singing and with dancing. And I made mention, when you give somebody something in my own village, in fact, in my compound, I don't know about your own. If you buy something and give to any member of my family, the first thing the person will do is to start dancing. Take for instance, you buy a wrapper and then give to your mother. The mother will first say, you first start singing. Praise the Lord. He will go and say, "O me kwala yaso, O mi hu, ti o me kwala yaso, O bo mi hu." And he is singing praises, or she is singing praises to the Lord. O me kere re re, ye 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 ye. That's how we dance. Praise the Lord. Appreciation goes with thanksgiving. It goes with dancing. When you thank God praise him, he raises you. When your heart is full of praise, God's hand will be full of blessings. And when you begin to praise him, he will now pour you down the blessings that you require. Yes, that's why Sammy said in Psalm 67 from verse 5. He said, let the people praise thee, O God. Let all the people praise thee. And then shall the earth yield her increase. What happens after the earth yield? And God shall bless us. And all the ends of the earth shall bear him. God shall bless us. And all the ends of the earth shall bear him. When your heart begins to pant after praises to the Lord, God comes down with blessings in his hand. And he's going to test you with blessings as you begin to praise him this week in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. A love of prayers. You have bombarded heavens with your prayers. It is time to start bombarding heaven with our praises and thanksgivings to the Lord. And as you praise God, I've said in first service, and I told them they should not thank God and they should not pray this week, but they should praise God this week. And then on Sunday, each and every one of you will have testimonies to share in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thanksgiving is appreciation, or is appreciating God for all he has done for you. That's what the psalmist did in Psalm 103 from verse 1 to 5. He thanked God for all he did for him. For he forgiveth all his iniquities, he forgiveth all his iniquities, he healeth all his diseases, he redeemeth his life from destruction, he crowneth him with loving kindness and tender mercies, he satisfied his mouth with good things, so that his youth is renewed like the eagles. You thank him for what he has done for you. Appreciation is an expression of gratefulness. Appreciation is an expression of gratefulness. Appreciation is an expression of thankfulness. Appreciation is an expression of gratitude to God. And I made mention of what appreciation is. Appreciation is making something bigger. Making something bigger than it were. As in, when you begin to make God to be bigger than he is, God begins to make you also to be bigger than you are. It's vice versa. That's why he said, I love them that love me. That means when you are making him big, he will also make you big. When you are trying to appreciate him, when you are trying to make him look great, because he can't come down and start making himself. Praise is the only thing God cannot give to himself. Praise the Lord. So but God wants you to give him what he cannot give to himself, so that he will do for you what you cannot do for yourself. Hallelujah. Yeah. Now let's look at dimensions of appreciation. Dimension of appreciation to God. A. Appreciating God for what he has done for you. Appreciating God for what he has done for you. Psalm 103 from verse 1 to 5. B. Appreciating God in anticipation of what he will do for you. It takes faith to appreciate God for what he has not done. But you thanking God because of what he has done, you have already seen what he has done, and then you start thanking, you begin to thank him. But thanking God in anticipation for what he has not done means that you have faith that God is going to do that which you ask of him. And it works faster. So you appreciate God for what he has done for you. In John chapter 12 verse 32, Jesus said, if I be lifted up, I will draw all men to myself. If I be lifted up, that is when you begin to lift him up, he draws you close to himself. And when you come close to himself, he blesses you. He sends his blessings to you. Habakkuk chapter 3 verse 17 to 19. The Habakkuk said, yet will I rejoice, though the fig tree does not blossom, though there is no heart in the tree, though the trees that I planted did not have any fruit on it. This man went forward to say, yet will I rejoice and be glad.
feet like hinds' feet. He believed that God is going to make his feet to be like that of the hinds. And God shall cause him to walk on his high places. When you begin to give God high praises, God blesses you in your high places in life. When you begin to thank him, when you begin to raise him, he raises you from where you are now to where you're supposed to be. Because inside praise has the power to raise or to rise. That's why it's P-raise. 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 Power to rise. Power to rise. Praise has inside of it power to raise you up from obscurity to limelight. And I see praise doing exactly that for you this week in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. When you begin to give God thanks for all he has done and all he has not done, he will bless you. In first service, we discussed why should I employ the force of appreciation. Why should I employ the force of appreciation? And then we said in first service, because God is the source of everything you have. God is the source of everything you have. What you have today is not because of your power. God gave them to you. The Bible says that every good and perfect gift comes from the Lord. It's coming from the Father of light, in whom there is no variableness nor shadow of turning. James chapter 1 verse 17. Every good and perfect gift comes from him. Everything you have came from the Lord. In 1 Corinthians chapter 4 verse 7, it says, for who maketh thee to differ from another? What have you that you did not receive? Now, if you did receive it, why do you glory as if you did not receive it? The little thing you have, you think is because of your power, because of your mind, because of your political people that you know. That's political affiliations. It's not because of the people, not even because of your qualifications, not even because of the job that you do that led you to have them. God gave them to you. Then in this second service, I'm going to number two. God qualified you and not you yourself. You have to show appreciation. You have to employ the force of appreciation because God himself qualified you. Understand that you are not qualified to be alive. We are not qualified to be alive today. Because if God could mark our iniquities, who shall stand? We are not qualified to be alive, but God qualified us to be alive. People died even this morning, but we are still alive. People are killed anyhow this time, but we are still alive. And because God qualified us to be alive. God qualified us to be alive. We did not qualify ourselves. Ephesians chapter 3 verse 8. Paul said that he is less than the least of the saints. Paul said that he is less than the least. Less than the least of the saints. But grace was given to him to preach the unsearchable riches of Christ. Grace was given to him. He is not qualified, but grace found him. He's not qualified, but God called him and qualified him. Because God does qualify the unqualified. God qualifies the unqualified. You need to appreciate him. You need to glorify him. He went further to say in verse 10 of 1 Corinthians 15. He said, I am what I am by the grace of God. I am what I am by the grace of God, knowing that without God, he is worthless. We are worthless without God. We are nothing without him. We are nothing. We are not qualified. In 1 Corinthians chapter 15 verse 9, he said, I am not qualified to be called an apostle. Do you understand it? I am not qualified at all, but God qualified me and then called me an apostle. So know that you are not qualified
to receive that blessing.
There are many other people who are qualified, who are more qualified than you, but God chose you to bless you. Number three, to express how much value. To express how much you value God's goodness and mercies upon your life. That's why you must appreciate it.
Daniel chapter 2, verse 23.
Daniel said, I thank thee and praise thee, O thou God of my father, who has given me wisdom and might, and has made known unto me now what we desire of thee. For thou hast made known unto us the king's matter. You have made known unto us the king's matter, expression of the value of his goodness and mercies. That's why you have to appreciate him. That's number three. You appreciate him, you show that you place his value on what he has done for you, his goodness and mercy. Number four, because God commanded us to appreciate him. Appreciation is a commandment. God commanded us to thank him. Malachi chapter 2 from verse 1. He said, now all ye priests, this commandment have I given. If you will not hear, nor lay it to heart, to give glory unto my name, I will curse your blessings. This commandment have I given to you. This commandment. So he commanded us to thank him, to give glory to his name. And there is a danger. If you don't give him the glory, he turns your blessing into curse. And he said, this commandment have I given to you, O ye priests, if you will not hear now and lay it to heart to give glory to my name, I will curse your blessing. That means the little blessings you have already, he will curse it. That's why we should lay it to heart to give glory to his name, in the name of Jesus Christ. And the dearest desire of every Christian is to keep the commandments of God. So one of the commandments of God is thanksgiving. You have to give me thanks. I command you today, give me thanks. If you don't give me that thanksgiving that I desire, I will curse your blessing. I will take the little one you have.
Praise the Lord.
Number five. Appreciation qualifies you for the next blessing. Appreciation qualifies the giver. Thanksgiving qualifies the giver for the next blessing, for the next miracle. Because when you pray on your kid, he will water another one. Praise the Lord. When you pray on your kid, he will water another one. When you thank God for his finger, you will see his mighty hand. When you thank him for what he has done, he will do more. That is the thing. Appreciation qualifies you for the next blessing. Luke chapter 17 from verse 17 to 19. Jesus said, were they not thankless? Were they not thankless? Where are the nine? How come that it's only you that is coming to thank me? Where are the other people? Now because you have come to thank me, your faith has made thee whole. The man Jesus made him whole. He qualified him for the next blessing, which is making whole. Jesus made him whole. His fingernails, his foot came out. Other ones were just healed of the wounds on their fingers and their truth. But this one that came back to give him thanks, he said, now your faith has made you now behold, the fingers shoot out, the cheeks pushed out, everything about the man became sound and hardy. So that appreciation paved the way for him to be made whole. And as you begin to thank God for what he has done and what he has not done, his blessing shall begin to be seen in your own lives in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Enough of complaining, enough of murmuring, enough of the praises God never answers. Stop it. Shut up. Start praising him and see how far. You don't pray. I see nothing is happening. Start praising and see if something will not happen.
And I see something happening for your case and in your case in the name of Jesus Christ. Appreciate Him. When you thank Him for what He has done, you are qualified for the next blessing. Now, how do we appreciate Him? Hey, appreciation must come from your heart. Thanksgiving must come from your heart. It must emanate from a grateful heart. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Ephesians chapter 5. Ephesians chapter 5, verse 19. Speaking to yourselves in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and making melody in your heart to the Lord. So praises must come from your heart, singing and making melody. Where?
In your heart.
In your heart to the Lord. Now verse 20 said, giving thanks always for all things unto God and the Father in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Giving thanks always from your heart. So your thanksgiving must come from your heart. It's not the one that somebody will push you to come and do. Come and give the Lord 20,000. Give the Lord. How many of us, 10 of us here, can give God 100,000? Come out and give God 100,000. Come and touch the man of God's hand. Come and touch the man of God with anything in your hand. Come and touch the man of God. And God will bless you. You can't hear that here. You can't hear us say, come out here. Those that want to give us 20,000, come out. Those that want to give us 50,000. And you see people who don't even have the money coming out. You know why? That sister, where they are, go say, you know, come out where they give 10,000. That brother, when they do Yangapo, because say, you don't get the money to come out. Here I went. And you see them coming out, and at the end of the day, they will still not give the money. You know why? They don't have it. The next thing, they will start avoiding the church. Because they don't promise man of God, say they will bring 10,000. You know, no? Praise the Lord. Ever since Conference House started, we have never called those that want to give us 10,000. Come out. Tell God. And you can't hear that here. Praise the Lord. We are not here to raise money. We are here to raise men. And when men are being raised, money will come. Money will come in quantum. May God use you as an avenue of blessings to Conference House International. Shouting every day that God should bless you. God should bless you to be a blessing to others. God should comfort you to comfort other people. That's why we are here. Shout hallelujah. Let it come from your heart. Nobody should bamboozle you. Come and give God 50. And then, do you know that there are some people who borrow, go and look for where they could borrow to come and pay that one? You don't do a man. You don't do a man. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
May I shock you? God knows the sin. God knows the sin. You see that God knows more about that. Because somebody persuaded you, forced you. It's not that God cannot tell you, give me 10,000. No, He can. But that one, when they come, if you want to give God 10,000, come out now. Come out. Man of God will pray for you. You will get plenty money. Master. I was. God can tell man of God, or He didn't speak to you, bring 10,000. Just if God can be very specific. He told Abraham, bring your son. Why did he say, bring your son and your wife? Why did he say, give me 10 cows? But he said specifically, give me your son. Give
something because he wants to use that to turn your situation around. But you sit like this, somebody goes, God, I want to give us 10,000. The Lord is hungry. The Lord is hungry. The Lord is hungry. Come and bring the money. Now watch. You can never hear that one here. We are not here to raise money. Our heartbeat is that it shall be well with you. God says, say ye to the righteous, it shall be well. That is our heartbeat here, that it shall be well with you. You know that there is the kind of money that God will bless you with. Nobody will even tell you, go and buy a car for the church. And I see many of you buying buses for God. Your pocket may not be or look like you are the one that will buy motor. It may not look like that. Your bank account may be lying now. Like my own is lying. Lying there. But I stand to declare to you, in no distant time, God shall bless you with blessings. If you don't give us 10,000, if you don't give us 20,000, no. Even when we buy our instruments, we say, now anything you know you have, you can give comfortably. Bring. Now, right?
Right, sir.
Anything you know. Let me tell you, the church contributed money more than 3 months for this drum.
That's right.
But I tell you the truth, there are some church that in one day they will get the drum money.
Yes, sir.
As he does announce the church in drop. Now, Sister Kachi, come and give us 50,000. Go and look for where you will borrow. Sister Day, go and look for people. Go and look for where you will borrow. Borrow to give God. Shalabaya.
I love my pastor.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
God called me. I didn't call myself into ministry. Those that call themselves, they call themselves to collect money. Collect money by anything. There are some people they want to attend to you. You first of all give 2,000.
Buy
cards, sir. You buy cards to see man of God.
Yes, sir.
Oh, that's scam. How are you? They want money. They don't even care about you. They don't care about your life, whether you live or you die. They don't care about anything. All they care about is your pocket. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let whatever you're giving come from your heart. You want to thank God, anything, let it come from your heart. And some of you, God will be saying, you see that your car, go and give it to the church. And you say, God forbid. Satan, I ban you. God may be saying to you, you see that 10,000 in your hand, go and drop it on the altar. And you begin to bind and cast. You are binding and casting your destiny. That is the truth. And I'm here to tell you the truth. Praise the Lord. Just like one sister, she's there. God said, go and buy olive oil for church here. The sister don't agree by. She one day be like, God, slap her. And they tell you, since to buy this thing, you know. She went to buy it and brought it here. Praise the Lord. And gave it to Pastor Daniel. Pastor Daniel gave it to me. I said, now open it, let's pray. He said, no, she gave it to the church. And God has said, he sure said, I thought, he said, God has been telling me to do it. But I have not done it. Now I did it. Say, but wait, when he goes snap you for the. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
God can speak to you, just be attentive. That one has plenty blessings advanced. See God blessing you in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The two cards that God gave to me, I give it out to people. Nobody forced me. God said, give it to this man. I carried it in. Give him everything. Everything. See? My heart is beating after helping people. To help people, not to dupe people.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Number B, you must dance to God with all your might. Psalm 149, verse 3. You know whether I get 10,000? They tell me to come and give 10,000. You know whether I get them? And the man of God looked me. I stand up front like this. The man of God said, come and give your 10,000. Everybody, and people were coming. And me, I stand by that bone. And I get 20,000 for my pocket. You know why I don't give? That one, no blessing is attached. No blessing. Because they forced the money to come up my hand. The man of God said, Saint Jude, won't you give the Lord 10,000? I said, I bring him here. Bring him here to my own mouth. You know where I get 10,000? The man of God come out. And my pastor, say now, go and give it. I will go on my own and eat. Gently and mildly. A week after the week of my marriage, as we came down from the moon, God said, pack everything in your house. Everything in your house. It's the same church. Pack everything. Everything in your house. Pack everything. The only thing I remember was light stool. You know why I remember what make my wife they sit down? New wife. My second name for where my wife is, he that scattereth. He that scattereth. Because he knows that I don't value what I have, I can give it out to anybody. My wife said, I'm afraid. I said, afraid of what? She said, because one day I can carry her and give to somebody. I said, no, I don't think I can. Give him in my life. Praise the Lord. Say, I wonder, I can give my life to somebody. So far as that my life will help you, I will give you. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You must dance to the Lord. Let them dance to the Lord. Psalm 149 verse 3. Let them praise him in a dance. 2 Samuel chapter 6 verse 14. And David danced before the Lord with all his might. When you are thanking God, especially in your house, close your door. Avoid any kind of distraction. Enter into your closet. Yet begin to dance it. Begin to shake it. Begin to dance to the Lord with all your might. Not this one that you do for church. You go to look for sister when they shake waist. So that you go say that. You think they will pay for club. You see sister when they do like this. You go say whether a club in there. You go just to look everybody the way they dance. Go to your room. Do one by yourself. Me, I used to dance birthday dance. Birthday dance. My naked and the naked. Everything. The Bible says, let everything that has breath praise the Lord. So when you are dancing to praise the Lord, everything, and he said, everything within me, let him bless the name of the Lord. They laugh, see your head. Everything within me, bless Psalm 103 verse 1. Bless the Lord, O my soul. And all that is within me, bless his holy name. You remove your cross. You dance for the Lord. Close your door. Not even your wife or husband should be there. It is only you and God. Dance and shake everything. What are you not talking about? And see God in action. Dance with your mind. The last one. You must come with a gift in your hand. You must come with a gift in your hand to the Lord. That's why that lady doctor in your village and people, your uncle, where no one make you become somebody. You know why sometimes your uncle defeats you? Because your uncle will go to the native doctor with our cooker. We go with fowl. We go with goat. Sometimes with cow. To thank native doctor for waiting they do for them. But you, when you come to the house of the Lord, you come empty hand. You come and say, why won't the native doctor give you? He will give you, he will stop your blessings. Because God is not seeing anything from you. And Satan is seeing plenty things from those that serve him. Why won't that finish you? And God is a jealous God. If you don't give it to God, you will give it to Satan. If you don't give it to God, you will give it to sickness.
If you don't give it to God, you will give it to people that will dupe you.
I hear that one,
sir. That is it. And Deuteronomy chapter 16, verse 16, he said, let nobody come to my presence empty handed. No enter here. Don't come and thank me without anything in your hand. I don't need that. Come and thank me with something in your hand. Thank me with your mouth. Dance and praise me. But come with something in your hand to thank me. Why did he say, Abraham, if I go to the mountain, I will bless you there? He said, go to that mountain with your son and give him. Give me your son. Give me your son. Your only son. God knew that Abraham had only one son. Meanwhile, Abraham had other six children. Abraham's second wife was Sarah. His first wife's name was Keturah, and she had six children, Abraham. But God didn't recognize them. Do you understand it? But he recognized Abraham. Isaac, give me your only son. That one where they thought only he had. Give me that one. Give him. Come here, go. And the man led his son. And your dad, I love. Where are we going? I got one of today, mama. And the boy said, nah, I need him to come. I need him, man. Yes, if I need him, man, don't you hear, girl? Say, they want to let you to let you go. Don't go to him, come there, girl. They want to let you to let you go. Now, Abraham, they want to let you to let you go. Don't go to him, come there, girl. They want to let you to let you go. Father said, his son said, Papa, where the sacrifice? We they go there now, we carry firewood, we carry cutlass, we carry knife. Where is the sacrifice? The boy don't know say na him be the sacrifice. When he reached there, he tied the boy, press him, hold on at least.
Carry hand up.
God said, Abraham, what you do? Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Servant. Layana kokoge ihe dukwu geme layana kokoge ihe dukwu geme layana kokoge ihe dukwu geme Abraham ndi watu leja turu chuka aja watu kama tsia and the boy, if I be the boy, I don't go forgive my father. Me and him go kill ourselves there. I tell you the truth. Oh, Papa, you won't give me here, eh? If not, a Nigerian person, then go to India. But the boy is saying, oh, Father, Father, sorry. Father, Father. Me? Me? Hey! As I sit there, the man won't kill you. I go first kill him. I go leave a man give me here. Yeah. Yeah, kill him. But wait. Give me here. Yeah. Give me heart to come fulfill my own destiny. But the boy forgive him. We don't hear say whether the boy is a danger. I can't watch one video that one guy did carrying the boy to go sacrifice as Isaac. When he go there, and the boy see saying to him, when one came, nine died with father. Collectively, God last. Say, go kill him, Papa. Then somebody comes him up. I will kill you, run away. I will kill you, run. I'll kill you, kill myself. Then our two will become sacrifice. Praise the Lord. Don't come to the Lord. Don't thank God empty handed. Even in your own house, when you thank God, raise an offering on him. You come and drop it on any altar of your choice. Praise the Lord. Come and drop it. Some of you even go to meet a man of God. Man of God, pray for me. You come empty handed. For your mind, you say you no get. You no get. That's why you come to see man of God empty handed. Sorry. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Exodus 23:15. None shall appear before me empty handed. Exodus 34 verse number 20. Don't come before my presence without a gift in your hand. No trial. Don't. Do not. That's how to thank God. That's how to bless Him. That's how to appreciate Him. When you thank Him, He blesses you. Even when you need something from ordinary human being, be giving the person something. I needed one great anointing from one man of God that I met. You know how I do it? In my hand, Lord, as I give, I receive this grace. As I give, I receive this grace. The man not be better man. But every time I go see and they give, the other side of him don't be right anything to the to your house, to home. About them. But I like one anointing in him. And I they go for him. And when I go with gifts, man. Gift, gift. And anytime I go and give, the Lord bless you. The Lord give it to you at the points of your need. The Lord sanctify the desires of your heart. What was the desire of my hand? The anointing on is your head. I need it. And now I'm operating on the anointing more than him. Do you understand it? But you go and hide it. Even if my father in the Lord called me to come, I know they go there empty. And they go there with something in my hand. Now he called you to come tell me something. Maybe something he wants us to iron together. He will call me and we go. And as I go, I give. I don't come to see you empty under the grace. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. That's a man. When you see a man going somewhere, he's a giver. That man of God visited us the other day. You think he left without something in his hand? He left with an envelope. I gave him something. What are you talking about? Why won't God bless me? I gave him something. And he collected it. You know what he said? This is Pentecostal handshake. That was what he said. That's me. This is Pentecostal handshake. When he got home, he called me back and said, thank you, sir. He has never experienced it like this before. Praise the Lord. For your information, I did not invite him. He invited himself to come and know whether I was in the year and true. And as he came that day, the message that day was just for him. Because he come to know whether or true. So he said, choose, now I'm a pastor. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And I think you see me standing here to preach. Is the one that to you? Is the case? God will begin to do wonders in your life from today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. But when God blesses you, please remember to bless others. Let it be your prayer. Lord, bless me to be a blessing. Not Lord, bless me to bless my family. In the grace. One day we went to buy something near Pastor Soro to go and share and give to people. And I happened to carry one carton. Say, now, since there is no food in my house, I can carry one carton of Indomie to keep for my own house, for my children. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And I carried it in, I entered, and left the other cartons with Pastor Soro. As I was going, my mind began to worry me. Why you go carry this one? Why you go carry them? Why you go carry them? I don't say you go there for your house. Return it back. Already carried the thing to my house. As I was coming back again, I still can't come back. Praise the Lord. You know, I say, even if hungry, go give my children, make it give them. But let's give to these people. I carried the thing, come back. And I was crying in my house. I was besieging, seeing people. Say, carry this thing. And I carried it to the house. And before I got home, somebody visited us with 3 rubber of rice with 10,000.
Hallelujah!
With 6 tubers of yam.
Wow.
What are you talking about? As soon as I withheld that one, come on. This one's not going to come. With money of 10,000. Praise the Lord. But some of you will be good, the one way you get, you cannot go. I say, even if you hungry, go give them, maybe give them there. Make I come and feed other people. My heart is always full of joy when I see people smiling because of me. Rise to your feet. Rise to your feet.
Before I got married, I was praying. I said, Lord, give me a woman that will have a heart to give to people. Without looking back. Give me a wife that will have a heart to give to people. I prayed on my own. I listed things that I needed in a woman. I listed it down and I keep it. When I met my wife, I don't know her. I don't know her. But God said, this is your wife. With time I get to find out that everything I listed was in her. Let me tell you one of the things I listed. I said I needed a wife that knows how to dance. Yeah? Dance. Praise the Lord. I needed a wife that knows how to sing. And for your information, I did not ask my wife whether you know how to sing. I don't ask her, you know how to dance. Huh?
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
May the Lord give you the desires of your heart.
Amen.
As I'm talking, God is showing me someone. He's showing me somebody that the hedge, the covering over you is breaking.
Amen.
It's breaking. Amen.
Amen for waiting.
The thing where God used to protect you, they break. In the shout, amen. German. In the lap. Praise the Lord. God is showing me someone. Your protection, the head over you is breaking. It's cutting up small, small. Breaking up small, small. And God said, I should tell you to be careful. God said, I should tell you, be careful, let the edge over you not break out for. Don't forget your spiritual practices. That's what he said. Don't forget your spiritual practices. And if your enemies are going to remove you from that edge, you are gone. You are gone forever. And I stand to pray for you this moment that no evil shall remove the edge over you in the name of Jesus Christ. Yeah. Not to be doing what you were doing before. So return back to Eden. And then the Lord will bless you in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Lift up your hands and bless the name of the Lord.